Hi, I'm Brittany from Mailchimp. In this video, I'll show you how to use Mailchimp's automation flows. We're going to build a new flow from start to finish. So, starting from the automations page, click Build from Scratch. Then, you'll name your flow and choose your audience. My business is the Potted Planter. It's a fictional plant brand for teaching purposes. My goal for this flow is to start engaging my audience with a welcome message to my new contacts, and I'd like them to explore the products on my website. I'll also include a discount code just in case they're ready to buy. And with that in mind, I'll name this flow Welcome Flow. First, I'll choose my audience and I'll click Choose a Starting Point. Now, think about who you want to target and what actions you want them to take. When you start with a clear goal, you'll have a better idea of how to structure your automation. This structure will take the form of a flow map, which visually represents all paths the contact can take. So it's like a blueprint of your automation. If a contact meets the conditions you've set for a starting point, they'll be added to your flow map. For instance, you may want your contacts who viewed your webpage or anyone who has responded to your survey to enter your flow. Some of our popular starting points are displayed here in the tiles, but you can also search under categories like contact activity and shopping activity. Each flow map can have up to 3 starting points. Essentials plan users are limited to 1. I want to welcome all of my new email contacts, so I'll just choose Signs Up for Email. Now you can include contacts you've imported and, for example, maybe you've uploaded a list of contacts through a CSV file. You can add a filter to refine who will enter the flow through the starting point. These filters are based on details in a contact's profile, their interactions with your marketing, and more. Keep in mind, some filters are not available on all plan types. So for details, please visit our pricing page. Now, once you're done with setup, click Use Segment. Now I'll go over flow steps. These are rules and actions that make up a flow map. Click Map to bring up your options. First, let's take a look at actions. These tell our system to perform tasks like send an SMS or send an email. Send email is the first action I'll use. I'll name this email Welcome. And click Save. I won't go over the rest of setup in detail, but normally you'd adjust the to and from name, enter a subject line, set the schedule and tracking, then design your email. That's all for this part. I'll click Close to get back to the map. To add another flow point, click the plus sign. This time, let's look under Rules. In Mailchimp, rules determine how and when a contact moves through the map. I want to send a follow-up email with a discount, but I don't want to send this right away. So I'll add a time delay. This rule prevents a contact from moving forward until a set time has passed. I'll set this to 2 days and click Save. After the time delay, I'll add another send email action and I'll name this email Welcome Discount. And to finish up, I'll click Save and close. All right, I think this map is just about ready to go. Keep in mind, your contacts won't enter the automation until after you turn it on. I'm all done here for now. So I'll click Continue to return to the Automation Flows page. Let's say you've turned on your flow. What's next? Well, it's important to regularly check in on your automations. That way, you can see what's working and what could use improvement. You'll find the status of your latest automations and stats on your contact's progress. For a more detailed look, click View Report. The last thing I'll cover is how to use flow templates. These are great if you want to get started quickly or if you just need some inspiration. You might not have access to all of our flow templates, so check out the details of your plan on our pricing page. To get started, click the button for Choose Flow Template. Let's take a look at all AI-powered flows. Intuit Assist works like an AI-powered marketing assistant. It generates emails, so all you have to do is review, edit, and publish. Intuit Assist is in beta, and it's available to certain customers with premium, standard, and legacy plans in select countries. Currently, we offer Intuit Assist in English only. Its features and capabilities vary by plan, which could change. To learn more, visit MailChimp.com. Moving on, you will find flow templates categories like find and welcome, transactional, nurture leads, and plenty of others. You can also use the drop-down menus to filter your search. To give you an example, I'll click apps and integrations and choose Shopify. I'm excited to show you how personalized a flow can get. So I'll click target contacts who view specific products in your Shopify store. After you click on a flow template, you'll see a description and a preview. When you find a template that works for you, just click Use This Flow. And that's about all I have for this video. Thanks for following along. And if you're new to this, a welcome flow is a good place to start. To learn more about marketing automation flows, visit our Help Center. Features and functionality vary by plan type. See MailChimp pricing for details.